Raw, uncut, and unapologetic. Welcome to Men Talking Mindfulness.
And also just think of, I imagine your body language. Imagine the body language of that want instead of like, hey, I need to talk to you. You know, like hands up, like, hey, we need to have a conversation instead of being like, you know, whatever that kind of anger was bringing your body language into. I'm sure it was definitely, I would have felt the aggression just the way you're talking about it. I would have probably got all defensive or whatever, you know, in that same situation. So it is on both sides, right?
Real quick, you've got a comment here from one of our viewers on LinkedIn, Martin. He says, the event example was not planned. Neither party planned for this. Therein lies the issue. And then he goes on saying each individual action are based on how they are wired.
Yes.
Hard to think through in the moment. Yes, absolutely, Martin. Yeah. But that's kind of one of the points in this conversation is that so many of these crucial conversations are not planned. And how we react in those conversations that are not planned is crucial, right? For lack of a better term.
Where are we playing from? Are we coming from a grounded, non-attached emotional place? Are we coming from a, you know, being, you know, drinking the emotional Kool-Aid and getting on that rush and then boom, like, and just reacting from an emotional place? Like, I think it's like really clear to like check in with the emotion. Again, that's why your meditation is so important. That's why it's important to, you know, get deeper into your breathing practices so you can literally regulate yourself in that moment.
Right.
Let's go to the next part here. So this is, again, we're breaking down what a dialogue is and what a conversation is. So in order for this to take place in a fruitful way, their safety is key, right? Safety from both sides. And this is what like the feeling within the dialogue. So I don't feel threatened by John, right? You know, I'm putting myself as the driver now. I don't feel threatened by John, but I can experience John as he has a problem and he's coming to me for that solution, right? Totally different way of doing things. So when you're feeling so here's what happens. There's two symptoms that arise, right? When we feel unsafe, right? So two things that kind of happen, or two ways that we can begin to behave when we're feeling unsafe, right? That's either we get silent or we get violent, right? When we get silent, our actions will be, even though we are silent, it'll be withhold. And actually silence is kind of we're withholding. One thing that says here, it's like purposely withholding information from the pool of meaning. And my behavior is I'm masking, avoiding, or withdrawing, right? The other way is the other side of it, the opposite is violence. And that's when we begin to get aggressive, begin to try to manipulate the conversation and start to point blame and you know, all those things that have come from like a violent way of being in this conversation because I don't feel safe. I feel threatened. So naturally, boom, my defenses come out either like it's kind of fight, flight, or freeze, right? So either fight back, either freeze or get really quiet or.
Those boil down to two forms of aggression. Active aggression, which is the violence, and passive aggression, which is the silence.
Wonderful.
My 5-year-old, almost 6-year-old, she will correct me if I tell, say, 5-year-old, she will say, I'm 5 5/6. Not even 5 1/2, I'm 5 5/6.
She knows fractions, Sean. Yeah, she comes from a geeky ass math father.
That's right. 100%, man. I'm like, you're way more than a half. Anyway, I regret teaching her fractions already. but yes, 5 5/6, this 5 5/6-year-old, if we're getting into father telling my daughter what she's doing is wrong, for instance, like sharing something with her brother, right? I'm like, hey, you need to share that, and she's like, fine, he can have it, and just like hands it over to him and then storms off to her bedroom. That's the passive aggressive side, right? That's the masking, the avoiding, the withdrawing. It's the silence. And then obviously going back to my example with the guy in the street, it almost came to blows. I've gotten into, unfortunately, I have to admit, I have gotten into fights in the past. I haven't gotten into any physical fights since I've been practicing meditation and mindfulness. So that's a win for meditation and mindfulness.
Listen to the full episode on our podcast, Men Talking Mindfulness, or watch it here on YouTube. Thanks for checking us out. MenTalkingMindfulness.com. Peace.